New World is nearing its first weekend and I'm here cruising for the forest bringing you 15 tips and tricks to make your start of the game as smooth as possible. This video is one of many to come in a series covering the game, so make sure to subscribe for more. Anyway, let's get right into it. Tip number 1. Get a 30 green wood from bushes and 10 flint from stones on the ground at the very start of the game. With this you can craft a complete set of tools to start gathering right away at the nearest campfire. Try to pick up everything you can, especially stones, so you can start mining iron deposits as soon as possible. Tip number 2. Speaking of gathering, nodes have specific static spawn points around the world. You can take advantage of this by making a map of your own or just using one of the interactive maps found online. This will help immensely with making farming routes later down the line. I have already made one for silver and iron deposits in Everfall, so make sure to check it out. More routes and spots are already recorded and I will be publishing them in the coming days. Tip number 3. Despite gathering nodes being static, they do not have set spawn times. There is a specific range that Amazon Game Studio adjusts based on the server's needs. They are currently very fast due to the launch of the game, but they will slow down when the initial rush calms down. Make sure to take advantage of this early. Tip number 4. To level up cooking fast early, you can use nuts. Those can be found all around the map and are used for tier 1 and 2 rations. Once you get energized, traveling rations unlocked, switch to those. You will need more ingredients, but those give huge chunks of experience, much more than any other option at this point. Tip number 5. The colors of damage values when you strike someone actually mean something. The orange color indicates critical hits. Blue colored strikes mean the enemy is resistant to this type of damage. Yellow means the enemy is weak to this type, and normal hits show white color. Attacking the back of an enemy or hitting their head with a projectile always results in a critical hit. Tip number 6. In this game you do not have a hearthstone in your inventory, but you can still utilize a recall option to your inn. This one can be found on the map after clicking on your home settlement. It has a lengthy cooldown of 1 hour, so make sure you use it when it counts. Tip number 7. You can increase your weight capacity by either buying or crafting a satchel. Those can be found in the outfitting station right off the bat, but can only be crafted after obtaining a minor rune of holding. You can buy those runes from your faction vendor after joining them and it will cost you 1000 of their currency as well as 250 gold. Also make sure to always upgrade your bag. Higher tier satchels exist and they increase your carry capacity even further. Tip number 8. You can get a water by just standing in a river or lake. Just press the E button. Make sure to do this once in a while because you need quite a lot for cooking and arcane crafting. Tip number 9. All this water will weigh quite a lot, but you can store it in one of your quick slots. This will make them weightless. You can stack up to 1000 water buckets in a slot, so make sure to take advantage of this. This is also true for other items that you can store there, like potions and food. Tip number 10. Speaking of weight, there are gear weight thresholds in the game, each providing you with different boni. It might be tempting to always use the most mitigation possible, but those boni are quite substantial. Light armor allows you to roll when you dodge and you will gain a 20% damage increase. Medium armor turns your dodge into a hop and you deal 10% more damage and healing. Additionally, crowd control effects you apply last 10% longer. Heavy armor turns your dodge into a slow sidestep. Your blocking stability is increased by 15% and crowd control effects you apply last 20% longer. Tip number 11. For those of you that like PvP, keep your sounds on. This game has a very good proximity detection when it comes to sounds, which lets you pinpoint threats and potential victims with great accuracy. Tip number 12. Make sure to explore the world. There are a lot of resources hidden around Aeternum, and you should always try to fill your bags. This is especially true for cooking resources. Turkey, rabbits, pigs, carrots, potatoes, corn, you name it. Everything is in a game and extremely valuable. This may seem tedious at first, but will eventually result in you sidetracking so much you won't be able to finish any quests. It's very, very fun. Tip number 13. Also make sure to get your harvesting to at least level 30 so you can harvest shrooms. Those are needed later down the line when doing your main quest. This will also enable you to gather essence plants, which drop modes. Those are needed for a lot of recipes and consumables, so always try to get them. Others will gladly buy them from you. Tip number 14. Some cities have beehives that can be gathered. Some have cows that can be milked. Salt and other cooking ingredients are also region specific, but those things can be found in supply crates, so make sure you always gather every crate you come across. The cooldown for everything mentioned is 1 hour, so quite lengthy. Tip number 15. Do not feel pressured into power leveling just because some players are higher level than you. The game is huge and there's lots and lots spots to explore and enjoy. Everyone will play this differently, and that's the best way to ensure a healthy community. You can also level quite fast per gathering and crafting, so do not dismiss this one. So, if you liked what you saw, make sure to subscribe and leave a like. I'll be uploading more tips and tricks, routes, economy videos and guides, and much, much more new world related stuff. To be honest, I'm blown away by this game, so there is a lot of stuff coming. Last Epoch content as well as MMORPG content is coming to this channel, but a little bit delayed. New World just has me this hooked. Anyway, that's all I have for you for now. See you next time and bye.